Apa lah pokoknya.
Assalamualaikum. Tak, audience semua bangun dulu eh. Ambil ke tempat ni.
Joget. Ya Allah ya Tuhan kami, dengan tema majlis pada hari ini perubahan yang positif, maka kami dengan penuh rendah diri memohon kepada-Mu ya Allah, tetapkanlah iman kami, tanamkanlah sifat-sifat positif dan terpuji ke dalam diri kami, dan jauhkanlah sifat-sifat sombong, curai, rasuah, mementingkan diri dan semua sifat-sifat tercela, agar budaya kerja yang berkualiti dan amanah menjadi amalan kami ya Allah, dan supaya kami sentiasa berusaha untuk melakukan penambahbaikan dalam syarikat, demi syarikat, demi organisasi Trust Teknologi Serang Bahar ya Allah. Allahumma ya Aziz ya Ghafar, kami mohon kepada-Mu nikmat rezeki yang halal sehingga kami tidak lagi memerlukan kepada yang haram. Allahumma ya Hanan ya Manan ya Bani as-samawati wal ard. Allahumma ij'al jam'ana hadza jam'an marhuhan wa taqarrukana hadza wa taqarrukana min ba'dihi taqarrukan maqsuman wa la taj'al fina wa la ma'ana syaqiyan wa la mahruman. Ya Allah ya Tuhan kami, jadikanlah majlis kami pada hari ini satu majlis yang dirahmati, dan perpisahan kami selepas ini adalah satu perpisahan yang diberkati. Allahumma rabbana atina fiddunya hasanah wa fil akhirati hasanah wa qina adzabannar. Ya Allah ya Tuhan kami, kurniakanlah kepada kami kebaikan dunia dan di akhirat, dan jauhkanlah kami daripada azab siksa api neraka. Wassallallahu ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Walhamdulillah rabbil alamin.
Oh,
all over and over again, you will always got the same result. So we need to change. Okay. Another thing, why now? Because based on you all dapat email the first year about class success story. We receive awards, Peter awards. So far on trust success story, kita dapat email. But what is our reaction? Overall, on you punya side, how do you feel? You feel good, but do you show your emotion? You show your emotion. The rest macam mana? We want you to show your emotion. That's it. Once we got success story, Surya kata kita dapat award, Akita Awards, MS 6 in 50 plus 50. Dapat award, okey lah. Senang juga you dapat award, tapi what's your reaction? Once you that, yes, kita dapat. Okay. We want you to show that. Yes, kita dapat. This is we want you to show your feeling. Kalau you senyap, ada feeling, you punya kerja pun sama juga gitu. Kita boleh agak lah. You punya kerja dalam situ, situ je lah. Okay. Once you show your feeling, then and another thing, as I said before, encourage others around you lah. Let's say, if you dapat something, you dapat award, you berjaya, let's say, main futsal you menang, you lumba lari you menang, but then, kita encourage, kita pun rasa, saya tak nak buat lah, then, and this sporting event, everything, kalau you all semua tak encourage then, oh, next time tak jadi lah, kan? But then, kita nak semua sama-sama encourage for the good thing lah. And then this is the thing yang oh yes this one kalau boleh nak you all boleh senang boleh lah senang boleh kita ada
bapa beri
so I just tunjuk how to change first you got to know your physiology your action must show by your action kalau you tak ada action then people will say you got to know your focus you must have focus kalau you tak ada focus focus on negative side, you focus oh, apa ni asyik diri je you kena focus mana yang positif
oh yeah.
And then, your language how you speak, how you talk kan, what? It will show you that is positive so, dia punya
Mr. Chairman, Jahir, Jusin, for being here.
Before I start, allow. Pokok betul ke? Tapi cuba kalau kita lihat kan. Katalah ada pintu nak masuk ke kelas tu. Kita lihat daripada pandangan orang luar. Ada seorang ni nama dia Muhammad Kamal Saleh. Dia nak jumpa teras. Dia nak bincang, nak ajak bermusyarat dengan teras. Rasa-rasanya mungkin kita jumpa dia, mungkin kita tak nak jumpa dia, kita tak kenal dia. Mungkin kita buat background study sikit entah dia. Pasal apa? Pasal dia ni not known. Kita tak tahu dia. Tapi katalah pula, Dato' Tuan Haji Omar, tadi pun telah nak jumpa teras. Rasa kita bagi tak dia tak? Kenapa kita bagi datang? Because kita recognize dia. Okay? Tapi katalah pula, Dato' Sri Najib Razak datang nak jumpa kita. Apa kita buat? Saya berani cakap ya, bukan setakat kita bagi dia datang. Kita berlari-lari pergi jumpa dia pasal dia nak jumpa kita. Kita pergi ke ofis dia. Kenapa kita buat itu? Because dia ni terkenal, famous. Kita tahu banyak tentang dia. Dan kita ada satu perasaan yang mungkin segan pada dia. Tak kira lah faham politik masing-masing, betul tak? That's beside the point lah. Tapi kita tengok, apalah nama teras? Google. Kalau dia sebut nama Google, Google ni sebenarnya dah tentang informasi.
Bagian tiket kita untuk tahun buku pertama 2008, kita telah menyiapkan beberapa produk-produk baru dan juga yang berkaitan dengan projek-projek. Okey, antara produk baru yang kita siapkan untuk tahun 2008 dalam 10 tahun pertama ialah 4 ticketing system. Di mana produk ini kita telah siapkan dan kita buat untuk trial di Rapid Penang.
Okey, dengan semua dalam keadaan yang biasa sangat saya cakap. So, why not kita buat dari sekali? Oh, yes tu? Tak ada?
Raji bersawa ni.
Nombor kedua. Satu, lapan, lapan. Lapan lagi.
Apa?
Satu, lapan, lapan. Ada. Yang ketiga. Satu, tiga, empat. Apa dia? Satu, tiga, empat. Rasanya nampak lebih berkuah.
Q2 sahaja, tapi akan menjadi landasan untuk Q3 dan Q4. untuk kita move forward ke depan. Kerana apa yang kita katakan ini adalah hari-hari, harian apa kita buat. Kita ini mengingatkan apa yang harus kita lakukan pada Q2 pada pasal 8 ini. Tujuh tips to be highly productive decision. Okay, tips-tips ni normal, you can kata 20, 30, 40, 50 tips. Tapi yang kita bincangkan tujuh tips untuk move Q2 sahaja. Kerana Q3 akan berubah, akan ada kata-kata hemat dari kita keluar lagi. Yang pertama,
saya kena
lah. Awang Teras ni buat kerja lambat lah apa. Padahal dia Awang Teras. Disalahkan dengan SDG lambat lah, projek lambat lah. No, you bila lah meeting, you jumpa klien, at any way, inside your heart, you have to be proud to be Teras. Upscale!
Yeah.
depan dengan seluruh bersungguh-sungguh. He shows dia punya passion dan dia punya enthusiasm. Okay. Terusnya, saya ingin jumpa Encik Nazami untuk menyampaikan ucapan dia, tajuk Why Moving to 2000 Car.
Boleh, boleh.
Untuk pertama
determines that the company will stay in the black, that we will march forward, go forward, and we will produce a green result.
How do you do that? We do. So without further ado, my presentation today will be on the financial performance as at 31st of March 2008, so for the last 3 months. Again, benchmark against our base budget and also against last year's performance. And I will therefore cover the key financial highlights. We focus on our revenue and also on our net profit of profit after tax and minority interest, PATAMI. I believe everybody will by now be aware that these two are the measures that are most important, especially to the performance of the company, our KPI. In addition, I will cover the revenue details, the revenue products for our three major products, which already we have seen the presentation from SED and also from FSS operations, showing what they've been pursuing this year. And lastly, I will cover the level where our operating expenditure is at. Alright, this one chart alone is already a handful because it's got five different measurements here. The key one being on revenue. Revenue for the year to date is at 6.9 million in actual, and we are trailing 10.2 million for our base budget for the 3 months. However, for our profit measures.
Hello, one question?
Saya wakil boleh pergi support. Okay. Saya nak ingin bertanya.
Tanya lah. Apa nak kena?
Kerja-kerja yang dah siap, adakah masih banyak lagi yang belum diklaim dan adakah klien masih lagi belum dibayar? Dibayar. Saya cek Jeffrey faham untuk sebab saya.
Me.
Masih lagi belum dapat duit, apakah tindakan final pada komisi yang masih lagi belum dibayar oleh kita?
About the receivables. Okay, because from last year, December, now we have about 25 million worth of receivables to receive. But for this first quarter, we managed to collect 18 million. For the 3 months. So now we are going to continue our efforts, especially to crack those some of those cases like Propel, Protect, that we're trying to clear those. So those are we need to sit down with them. And also we have to look at how we can support those revenue that we worked on, we have done. Currently on hand is about 11 million to convert them to certified green. So these are the value that finance and contract would support all of you, especially in operations, yeah, to get that in time. Okay? So this is I hope that it's okay with you.
Okay.
Any more questions?
Clear.
What about how much to pay for your bonus?
Yeah. I love you lah.
It's already in place, alright?
We have more to do, Alan. Thank you very much.
Okay, Jack.
Now, I would like to call upon Nur Azina
to
speak about the thrills of working with us.
Okay, assalamualaikum dan selamat petang kepada management team, especially to Chen, welcome and all. Okay, untuk pengetahuan semua, for information, employee benefit ni board paper just approved by our board of director in March 2008. However, don't worry because the implementation will took effect starting from 1 January 2008. But I think this is the right time untuk saya officially announce lah on the revisions of our employee benefit. Okay, so the purpose of benefit revision, yeah? The first one for sure to be market competitive, and the second one is to show that our company is a caring organization towards employee and their dependents. And the third one is to improve our corporate image. Okay, so as you can see on the screen, semua benefit yang listed here are the benefits affected during this exercise. Tapi saya takkan cover semula because some benefits tu for senior management. Okay, so the first one, hospitalization. Okay, so this is the previous entitlement. And that's the new rate. So if you can see that non-executive, kalau dulu entitlement per annum is from 8,000 to 10,000 ringgit per annum. But now, semua kita dah streamline for non-executive dah up to 30K per annum. Okay. So, sama juga macam executive, semua naik daripada 10K up to 50K, same as work rate. And also for the managers and above. Operation medical treatment. This is the previous entitlement. Semua kita has already ascended to non-executive. Jangan pula tarik sebab dengan executive medical screening tapi non-exec tak boleh, tapi sebenarnya non-exec pun entitled for this benefit. Cuma kos mahal lah kot. So kena bajet-bajet lah untuk guna RM3,000 setahun ni. Okay. So for winter clothing, this one to those staff yang business travel to overseas. Okay, kalau dulu hanya entitlement tu hanya limited to executive, but now it's also extended to non-executive staff. Okay. Kalau ada co-season, okay lah buat ini. Okay, so for parking fee subsidy. Okay, that was the previous rate. And after the revision, they are streamlined. All junior management from junior executive up to assistant manager, semua boleh claim up to RM60 per annum. So, saya tahu ramai yang tanya saya sebelum ni macam mana kalau yang claim Januari, Februari tu. So kalau macam yang season parking yang dah submit, dah already submitted to HR, that one we will automatically reimburse for you lah. Tapi siapa yang macam daily basis, kalau still ada lagi original receipt, and then you can submit.
Alah je.
Okay, so this is about staff insurance coverage. Saya rasa ini pun ramai staff yang tak tahu kot yang company kita actually ada cover. Kalau you baca betul-betul dalam offer letter or in our employee guide, ada terangkan pasal group term life insurance and group personal accident insurance. Okay, so 207 coverage. Okay, so 208 coverage. Kalau you nampak sekarang ni that entitlement tu dibagikan kepada ikut job band, junior management lain, middle management lain, senior management lain. So sekarang ni if anything happen to you, group term life ni, faham ke group term life untuk apa? Insurance nyawa kan? If anything happen to you, tak kisahlah kalau you, kalau staff lah yang meninggal waktu tidur ke sakit jantung pun, so your next of kin boleh dapatlah this amount. But it's still up to the company whether want to pay direct to the staff. The next of kin ataupun tengoklah berapa yang company nak bagi. Sebab yang ini minat company yang calonkan untuk you. Okay. Sorry?
Assalamualaikum semua. Selamat petang.
Mengucapkan pada Terusin, Rahim, rakan-rakan manajemen dan keluarga teras seluruhnya. Ya. Saya sebelum saya mulakan tentang topik ini, saya nak jawablah soalan tadi. Murahnya jamu non eksekutif. Sebenarnya bukan macam itu. Kita kita bagi eksekutif benefits, we also give a non-executive benefit kan. Different benefits for different group of employees. Tapi kita bagi executive tu lebih sikit. Sebab apa? Kita nak motivate non-executive ni perbaiki diri jadi dia boleh naik kepada executive. Itu sebenarnya. Jadi bila umur yang meningkat kan, bila umur yang meningkat, you will be better. And then orang muda-muda yang masuk jadi non-executive, itu motivation yang kita bagi lah. So take it positive eh. Maknanya dalam 5 tahun lagi, 10 tahun, saya tak nak tengok you jadi non-executive. I nak jadi you jadi executive.
Boleh
tak? Boleh?
Boleh.
Yeah. Okay, saya terpanggil nak buat presentation managing individual performance ni pasal kan tadi Aino suka cakap pasal KPI. Tahun ni kan, all about KPI. Ada adalah rumutan-rumutan sikit kat grassroots level tu kan, tentang KPI yang kita buat untuk tahun ni. So, I as the HR person need to come up here and explain to you, okay? What is the KPI framework untuk tahun 2008? So that we all have common understanding, kita semua bekerja bersungguh-sungguh untuk capai apa yang kita inginkan eh. Mana? Okay, ni seorang sebenarnya kan KPI untuk head of company and KPI for head of division, KPI for head of department, okay, adalah berbeza dengan KPI yang you all tengok atas skrin ni. Okay, now KPI, head of company memang berat lah kan. Sebagai head of company, berat dia punya tanggungjawab. Head of division kena tampung, kena support KPI. And head of department kena support head of division KPI. As an executive and non-executive, you all semua ni kena support you punya head of department ni KPI. Okay, itu faham kan setakat ni. But as passionate as this as I am lah. Sebab apa, as our chairman of this quarterly briefing said that we all need to change that. So take this positively. Don't look at the negative, don't cakap-cakap belakang kan. If you have anything, like I know say, face up. If you don't like it, you face up. Talk and say, no, we do not want this. Tapi talking, among yourself doesn't change anything. Okay, doesn't change. Okay, next is the compliance to individual service level. This is also very important. Some of you are being tracked using TAMS. Some are tracked using CRM. Okay, so this will be how responsive you are in responding to this request. Okay, quality improvements involve things like a continuous improvement team to introduce flexi hour. You can do that, okay? So you can measure the before effect of flexi hour. Before we have flexi hour, we work 8:30 to 5:30. This is the productivity, for example. Now we introduce flexi hours. These are the after result. So you can even do that. You can make the changes at your level. Don't wait for and start with yourself. Okay? Be proactive. Yes. Next is the point in corporate social responsibilities. This is so that Teras is not just seen as selling system saja. We are also seen as somebody who cares for the community. Yeah, macam sekarang ni, Teras quite famous lah. Itu ada CSR, Opus, tapi Teras belum lagi. So, we want every staff to feel their commitment to improve the society at large. Okay, so this one you take initiative, you lead and you get the points. Question?
Oh, no,
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Merangkumi ya.
You can actually introduce Teras, okay? Introduce this activity to Teras, and of course you got to get the management approval lah. So once management say that okay, this is a good corporate social responsibility, then we can participate in terms of not necessarily just bagi duit kan. Kita kan IT Miora, why don't we set up website to dia ke? Actually those yang don't comply with the code of conduct,
they can be disqualified from the bonus exercise increment. Tapi for us, we still, thanks to Tuan Hussein and Cik Rahim, we still pay out to you, but we deduct the percentage too. Now, moving forward, as far as possible, kita kalau boleh tak nak, we do not want to moderate at the end of the year. So what we will do is HR and PTN is actually going to go through your PMS and make sure the KPI set to solid, not an easy KPI. So what the KPI is clear. Memang. I umpamakan macam you bunuh lah kan. That one extreme lah. Tapi kesalahan telah dibuat. Kesalahan sudah dibuat. You kena penalize for it. But you need improvement tu kita acknowledge. But if you have made a mistake and that is against, it doesn't comply.
Yes, benda tu memang salah. Tapi kita ada perubahan. Adakah perubahan tu tak dilihat secara global? Adakah itu salah-salah? Kenapa? Saya dah berubah, bos. Bila saya dah berubah, bos, saya berubah hukum saya. Dah lah kena mental torture. Kena berubah kena berubah. Tapi dah ada perubahan, tetap kena menerima oleh management. Kena tetap tengok perubahan tu. Bukan ni, kita tak nak benda ni terjadi lagi akan datang. So, benda ni terjadi sekarang. Kerana berlaku kesalahan di awal tahun, tapi kita nasihat ada perubahan. Thanks to management kerana care about us, bagi nasihat and berubah. Tapi bila keluarnya banyak, kena hukum juga. So, adakah perubahan tu yang benda ataupun hukuman tu yang nombor satu?
Okay, soalan saya nak jawab macam mana. So, it's just that, maknanya, it's good that that improvement happened. So kita hopefully tahun ni tak ada dah lagi kan, tak ada dah lagi perubahan, tak ada dah lagi isu-isu tentang disiplin. But the point is, we don't want to discuss benda tu lagi. The point is, if mistake has happened, you have to be told that it is wrong. Itu saja.
Dihukum orang lah, salah berubah, dihukum. Jadi ada yang berubah.
Under my privilege, will give them approval to come back. Is that fair? That is my question.
Okay, kita ada prosedur kan. Memang our working hours is from 8:30 to 5:30. And our procedure say that if you are going to be late. Okay, I think the question is not why HR, why you do not ask yourself to issue the cumbersome form, okay? In fact, you are not aware, you say your staff inform you that they will be late, kan? So you know the procedure, you know the guidelines.
Yes.
Why is it so difficult for you to ask them to fill out the cumbersome form?
And why it's only end of the year?
No. I'm telling you that why I'm not saying why that idea. I'm asking the bosses to we have a policies and procedures just to comply with the thing. Because kita punya X5000 system tak not secanggih yang kita harapkan lah. Where you can where. We should be managing our own attendance and self-regulated. Don't wait for HR. Because HR is not supposed to be we are the custodian of the process and procedure, but in terms of attendance and all that, it should be self-regulated, or at least the department head should manage this. Okay, time to change.
So I think in the future, to be fair to the staff, kalau staff datang lambat, ada latecomers, staff kena penalized. The head department also kena penalize sekali because not complying to procedures.
Yep.
So why won't the staff be penalized?
Okay, that's a good suggestion. We will implement it this year. Good suggestion. So okay, you know what to do, eh? Okay, you know what to do, eh?
Tak ramai, orang okay lah.
As I say, kalau you have any issue to discuss, you can always discuss after the session. All right, I thank you very much, and I hope you have a pleasant evening.
Saya Puan Aida, saya nampak kesungguhan kita punya staff untuk memberi soalan berkaitan teruskan berkaitan attendance. So kita teruskan dengan lucky draw lah. So bagi korang buat satu sikit lah. Okay. So dia jemput Cik Rahim untuk membuat sambutan. Nombor yang pertama 019. Thank you. buat pengakuan semua ya, haji-haji ni sebenarnya sumbangan daripada komiti. Terakhir sekali, 1-7-3. Ada? Ada? 1-7-3. Ada? 0-7-5. Banyak nombor 7 ni.
Lu wakil kita orang tu.
Okay, sekarang kita teruskan dengan sesi soal jawab dan Encik Rahim. So jika ada apa-apa soalan boleh.
Ini saya tak buat sembahan ya.
Thank you.
Bayaran bonus
Itu saya akan membuka hati. Dan satu lagi yang saya nak tegur di sini, walaupun telah dibentangkan syarikat ini telah menangi award-award, tapi apa yang saya rasa kurang yang perlu dilakukan oleh syarikat keras ialah menonjolkan lagi berita-berita yang positif berkenaan pencapaian keras. Okay. Apa yang you dapat seperti mana you kata Silver Award pada Excellent Conference, APITA Award. Okay, you are the 6th, okay, best performing of the 50 companies. Yeah. Yang sedihnya, Teras sebagai satu syarikat dan mungkin kaki tangan Teras tahu dengan capaian ini, bagaimana yang dikenalkan. Tapi UM Group secara keseluruhan, okay, berita ini belum dapat disampaikan. So, saya mengalahkan pihak tertentu, management yang tertentu. I think you have to make sure that you communicate and share this information because this is your achievement. Okay? Dan satu lagi, saya rasa memang sesuai kalau Teras minta ruang dalam UM punya berhenti di mana masukkan pencapaian berita-berita dengan pencapaian ini supaya komuniti di UM dan luar daripada UM boleh baca kita punya newsletter. Dan satu lagi, di mana yang Cik Surya kata, kita dah kenal pasti siapa chefnya, siapa janitornya, siapa cashiernya, okay, siapa beritanya. Tapi dia sendiri, sebagai jurujual, dia hanya gunakan sales marketing. Okay. Dan satu apa yang saya dapati, Cik Aida, I think you make a very good tadika punya cikgu. Bila you cakap Pepsi, apa dia P, semua jawab. Apa dia E, apa semua jawab. So I think, you know, you are well cut for, you know, dan cikgu lah. The other thing, okay, now on the, what I need for you to see, topik-topik. Okay, topik-topik yang dipilih, kalau boleh, okay, macam tiap-tiap senior management yang datang ke atas, kalau you boleh pilih topik-topik yang high priority untuk dikemukakan untuk pengetahuan dosa. Okay, I think it's a good beginning, apa yang kita dapati. Tapi things like macam Surya, think what you should share. Pencapaian revenue berbanding dengan 06, peningkatan adalah sebanyak 24%. Dari segi EBITDA, peningkatan adalah sebanyak 29%. Kalau kita banding keuntungan berbanding dengan bajet, syarikat Teras telah mencapaikan 57% keuntungan. Berdasarkan itu, saya ingin nyatakan UM telah menyokong untuk Teras membayar bonus yang lebih tinggi daripada tahun 06 atau dibayar 07. Tahun ini, secara puratanya, bayar bonus termasuk salary adjustment adalah sebanyak 7.7% berbanding dengan 6.7% tahun lepas. Dan dia punya bonus secara puratanya adalah 3.6 bulan berbanding dengan 3 bulan tahun lepas. Also, I at 4.7. Itu yang ini. So, I think your bonus is going to be paid end of the month. So, tahniah saya ucapkan kepada semua di atas pencapaian yang telah saya nyatakan. Hanya untuk tahun ini, apa yang saya dapati prestasi sejak bulan 3, ya, seperti mana yang dibentangkan, ada your profit number is behind. So that's something you have to work on. Okay. And I think your revenue is very much behind. Dan dua perkara yang saya dapati, ini satu yang saya nak galakkan lagi, the sales and marketing dengan SDD punya expenditure is very, very low compared to budget. And that worries me. Because you don't spend, okay, you're not going to be getting your sales. If you're not spending to budget, you're not going to get your new products and your innovation. Okay, so these two areas, okay, you should not short spend. Okay, balik. Okay, duit dah bagi. Tapi tak henti nak belanja. Okay. Macam Surya, in your sales marketing, even though it's the first 3 months, you must keep the same pace of momentum. Tak boleh, first 3 months, too slow. Okay, last 3 months baru nak. Okay, because this is the collection of your order book. You know, it's on every day of the effort. Okay, so dengan itu, saya sudahi dengan Abdullahi Fatih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Jemput Cik Rahim naik untuk bonus letter. First of all, I would like to call upon Cik Aziz bin Nazim on behalf of Mr. Division. Cik Nazaman Nazaruddin on behalf of Social Marketing Division. Encik Baharin Sarif on behalf of System Development Division. Madam Liu Pocio on behalf of Finance and Contract Department. Puan Nur Azhar Saleh on behalf of Admin and Helpdesk Department. Encik Ahmad Han bin Jaafar Han, Puan Nur Aidah Mokhtar on behalf of HRPPM. And last but not least, to Cik Abdul Rahim Suliman.
Therefore, find your team.